fuck, mate. You know what I'm fucking saying, mate. You know what I'm fucking saying, mate. Is it just me? Does everybody seem to be fucked up, feeling head? Had enough of living, wanna be dead. Just one square mile, so much trouble, it's fucking vile. I'm just walking to get home, mate. I just want to survive, leave me alone, mate. Is it just me, or does everybody seem to be fucked up round here? I'm living in fucking fear, just walking a few miles just to get home, mate. But I feel like a fucking target all alone, mate. Is it just me in my head? Is it paranoia? I simply can't enjoy a walk down the fucking road without feeling like a little toad. Like a little fucking toad. Something to be trod on, something to be splattered and twatted all over the road. You act like a fucking twat. You act like a fucking twat, mate. You know what I'm saying, mate. You know what I'm fucking saying, mate. Clench me fist, need a piss, keep me eyes peeled, because I feel that every fuck you're walking past is gonna have a pop or a blast at me, nasty to me, vicious and moody. I'm gonna have to fight just for the right to drag me Sam back home, just to be alone, to breathe again, to be free again. And it sometimes makes me wonder how I keep on going under. You sound like a fucking twat. You sound like a fucking twat, mate. You know what I'm saying. You know what I'm fucking saying, mate. Everyone's a fucking twat, mate. Wishing everyone was dead, dead. All the buildings, they are cracked. All the cities, they are dead. All the humans gone in my head. Gone in my head. Quiet times, life is mine. Waste my time until I die. Quiet times, life is mine. Waste my time until I die. Brain driver, paralyzer, locks in summer school. Feeling fears unethical. Brain driver, paralyzer, locks in summer school. Feeling fears unethical. Brain driver. Brain's over. Brain's over. You decide. Oh, on the path you take, on the mess you make. Brain's over. You decide. Oh, on the path you take, on the mess you make. Brain's over. Sweats in the middle of the night. Dried up mouth, eyes are red. Legs are red. Thinking everyone was dead. Dead. All the babies, they are cracked. All the sisters, they are dead. All the humans gone in my head. Gone in my head. Quiet times, life is mine. Waste my time until I die. Waste my time until I die. Quiet times, life is mine. Waste my time until I die. Brain driver, paralyzer, locks inside my skull. Feeling fears unethical. Brain driver, paralyzer, locks inside my skull. Feeling fears unethical. Brain driver, you decide. Oh, on the path you take, I'm the mess you make. Brain driver. Brain driver.
consequences of the British pit closures in the early to mid-1980s were felt far and wide throughout the intellectual community. In a now infamous interview in 1987 with an anonymous coal miner from Derbyshire, who is simply referred to as Tony, it is revealed how Margaret Thatcher's plans to transform labour demand dynamics in the UK were in part influenced by a primal desire to tear apart social cooperation and worker solidarity in the name of the practitioners of the dark arts, such as Aleister Crowley, Leslie Crowther, Shirley Crabtree, and other seminal libertarians and occultists. Tony helped my own late father, the Labour MP Chives Radstock, to formulate a feasible exit plan from the Union headquarters on the corner of Mill Street by the old Tudor chip shop, straight down to the damp and mossy caves located around the back of the Department of Agriculture, now of course defunct and replaced by a winning combination of soft tissue and short variegated conifers. For Tony's part in this ruse, we as a nation shall forever be grateful. That, of course, goes without saying. Tony, like so many other squat, curly-haired men, was born on the cusp of Eden in the late 1940s, emerging from a dramatic backdrop of semi-phased limestone quarry-based local theatre and an eternal sense of almost Wagnerian injustice. After graduating from the LSD in 1966, Tony mined voraciously for 18 years until the impassioned strikes of 1984, whereupon he abandoned his previous allegiance to the cajoling approach of Antonio Gramsci at the Frankfurter School in order to take up residence at the pioneering Freedom Cottage, a rather sordid squat on Charing Cross Road, then run by Charlie Stammers, the lead singer of the punk band Mucus Patrol. We all know what happened next, of course. A cultural paradigm shift resulting in tens of thousands of boxer dogs being freed into the East Anglian countryside, only to be recalled later in the name of moderation, prudence, fiscal incision, and moderation. Situation where the whip hand resulted in a new synthesis of left-wing politics and post-feminist literary analysis, foaming at the anus and gyrating almost daily. This unholy pairing of rustic artisanal urban demagogue has produced some of the finest quatrains in recent history. We arrive at an almost erotic conjunction today, where no man who considers himself above the simple cattle in the field can reasonably hold his head up high and bleat. I am aware of my own nostrils, my hands, my feet, for they are tools designed by the Elder Ones to rend, to drown, or simply to apprehend all incomers to the Garden of Fortune. The at once pleasing design of the adjoining Cadbury estate hides a rather more sinister intent, and one that will be revealed only when the stars align with kettle and with cactus. We can only pray that that point is many, many years away, hidden in the ether of the musky Levantine evening. The strains of traditional Moroccan music, the desperate mating calls of spiteful little frogs, the hooting of a giant brass owl, all this adds to the impending sense of failure of one's own career, and more importantly, the general failure of the West to reconcile tradition with consumer comfort. Thus, we arrive at a conclusion to the interview with the ex-miner Sir Tony of Gladwell. A conclusion that merely points to the end of history as realized by a fecund and fertile form of lysergic capitalism. A mode of production that knows not of material reality, but only of lascivious and cyclical dreams, born aloft in the dying.